Hello everyone and welcome back. I am your host, Elias Sarantopoulos. In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to create a vector badge inside Affinity Designer for iPad. We will use the pen tool to draw the vector object, we'll write text, we'll import and clip images and shapes, we'll learn how to use gestures, and export our work in various file formats. We've got a lot to cover, so let's go ahead and dive into it. Inside Affinity Designer, let's go ahead and tap on the plus icon to create a new document, and then tap on the new document icon. And for device, I'm going to go for the print option. A4 is fine, but for orientation, I'm going to tap on the landscape and then tap OK. And now we have a new and empty document. Now, before I start drawing anything, let's go ahead and set up a couple of things. So I'm going to tap on the document menu here, and I'm going to look at the snapping options. So I'm going to enable snapping, snap to grid, because I'm going to have the grid on, and then snap to layer bounding boxes, and then tap done. Another thing that I want to look into is the grid. I want to have the grid on, so you can toggle off and on the grid. So in this case, we're going to show grid. And for the grid mode, I'm going to go for the standards. Now at the left side, we've got the toolbar. And at the bottom left corner, we have the snapping options. Right now it's on, off, on, and so on. So you're going to see me doing this. All right, so let's go ahead and use the rectangle tool. Let's go ahead and create a rectangle like so. Okay. Now, I would like to actually add some nodes or some anchor points. And there are a couple of ways you can do this. At the very bottom, we have the context toolbar. And we have a choice here. It says to curve, which means convert this to curves. You can also do this by the edit menu. And you have this choice here, convert to curves. So let's go ahead and do that. And now with the node tool, and I'm going to add one node here. Just make sure it snaps right there. Add one here as well. Okay. Let's put this in the center. And then let's bring this up a bit and then drag this downward. Let's bring this in. Something like that. Okay. So for this node and this node, I would like to have a smooth curve. Again, at the very bottom, we have the context toolbar. And the second choice we have is the smooth. So tap on the smooth, tap on the other node, and smooth that out as well. So we have two of them. Probably going to bring this in a bit, like so. And then between this node and this node, I would like to have a curve. So right around the center, tap and drag to create a curve. Let's do this one here too. Create another curve. There you go. And I think this looks good. You can also change it according to your liking. Okay. So let's go ahead and get rid of the grid, like so. And let's make sure that sits right in the center, like so. Okay, so let's go ahead and select this. Let's give it a color. So let's go to the color studio here. And let's see, no need for stroke and just a fill. Let's go to the swatches. Pick any color you wish to use. And then let's go to the Layer Studio here, the Layers panel. What I want to do is I want to duplicate this actually. Okay, so I'm going to tap on that and then go to the Edit menu and then duplicate this. All right. Now, what I'm going to do is I want to size this down. But first, let's give it a stroke at the same time and maybe change the color. So tap on the Color Studio. Change the color. It doesn't really matter at this point. Add a stroke. But as you can see, I barely have any stroke. Right now it says the stroke studio says 0.2 points. Basically nothing. So how do we increase the stroke size? Well, we have the slider here. That's one way. Or you can tap on the numeric value here. Okay. Or even easier, you can use your gestures. So you can scrub this up or down and change the stroke. Okay. Now let's go ahead and size this down. So I'm going to make sure that I don't have the snapping option on. So no snapping. And what I'm going to do is actually I'm going to start sizing this, but also put three fingers down on the canvas, which it will resize around the center point and also constrain the aspect ratio. Now here, let's go ahead and change the cap style. Right now we have a round cap style. So inside the Stroke Studio and under the Advanced Options, go ahead and change the style from round cap to butt cap. In addition, change the stroke alignment to centered. Now the stroke of the inner curve is a bit large, so I'm going to reduce the size by scrubbing down and also increase the overall size of it, like so. So let's go ahead and add some elements here. So I'm going to tap on the rectangle tool and I'm going to tap and drag one like so. Now let's go to the color studio. No need for stroke. Color, let's say it's black, but this needs to be actually be clipped on the on this curve. So I'm going to tap on the rectangle. I'm going to tap and hold and I'm going to bring this right on top. Not below it, right there, right in the middle, right on top. Boom. And now this is clipped. Of course, you can size this up and down to your liking. So we have something like that. And then let's go ahead and add some text. So I'm going to tap on the artistic text tool. Okay. And let's say I'm going to tap once. So for color, let's use white, and I'm going to call for mountain. There we go. Okay, I'm going to size this up, and I'm tapping two fingers of the canvas to do so. And the other way is actually you can increase the size, the size of the type. So you can tap on the here, as you can see, it says the text studio. There we go. So we can, first of all, let's change the font instead of Arial. Let's say go for Helvetica. And then for typography, let's make sure we have caps on. What else can we do? Well, I want to size this down. So an easy way to do it is using the gestures again. Again, scrub this up. Scrub this down, but I want to do this from the center. So tap on the center. There you go. Something along those lines. Okay. Now I need to make a duplicate. So there's a way to do this. You can actually hold two, you can tap two fingers of the canvas and then drag. See that? Quite easy, right? Now, in this case, let's double click. Let's change all that to, exploration. The thing is, this is too big. Okay, so I need to size this down. There we go. Instead of regular, I'm going to go for light. Bring this up here. And now for positioning, I can actually change the tracking and I can do this with my gestures. Something along those lines. Okay. There we go. Like so. Another thing we can do is actually add a photo inside the inner shape. So I'm going to tap on the Layer Studio here. And then I'm going to bring as a sliding app, the Photos app here. There we go. I'm going to tap and hold and bring this photo inside the canvas, like so. And I'm going to pinch to zoom out because this is quite large. So I'm going to size this down and I'm tapping two fingers at the same time in the canvas. Okay, let's bring this closer around here. All right. And now this photo has to be clipped inside this curve right below the rectangle, not inside the rectangle, but below it, like so. Okay, we have a bit of room to size this down. There we go. Okay. So another thing we can do is actually we can bring in, an icon. So for that, I'm going to tap a bring in slide the files app. I have an axe here. I'm going to tap and bring this in, like so. And then from the menu here, from the tools, I'm going to use the ellipse tool. I'm going to tap and drag. And I'm not looking for anything specific, to be honest with you. Because this one, let me change the color to have the same color as this, will sit right inside. So tap and hold and bring this under the rectangle. There we go. And I'm going to tap on that. I'm going to bring this here and just size this down. And I'm tapping two fingers on the canvas, like so. Now let's go ahead and save our work and then export it in various formats. First, I'm going to save my work as an Affinity Designer native format. So I'm going to tap on the document menu and then tap on the save a copy. Okay, so let's give it a name. That will be badge, let's say. Hit enter return. Let's go ahead and save that out. I'm going to save it back on the cloud. There we go. Now let's go ahead and save in other file formats. So tap on the document menu and then export. So right now, for example, I have the PNG option. So for the PNG, I would like to have a transparent background, but I cannot accomplish this the way it is. So I'm going to cancel that out. And there are a couple of ways you can do this. You can either marquee select everything, then tap on the document menu, and then tap on export. And then under the area, you can choose selection with background or selection without background. In this case, I would have selected selection without background, but I'm going to cancel that out. I'm going to show you another way, which is tap on the canvas and then tap on the transparent canvas. You see? So now this is transparent. So I'm going to export this. It's PNG. And I'm going to change the name again to, let's say, badge. Hit enter return. I'm going to go for PNG to 24 and I'm going to leave everything as is. So I'm going to tap OK. And I'm going to save that out again. Back on the export, let's go for SVG. Again, let's change the name, hit enter return, and I'm going to leave everything as is. You have options here, by the way. You have the export for print and so on. Just going to leave it as is, and then tap OK. There we go. And last one is the PDF option. Again, you have a lot of presets here for print and so on. Just going to leave as export. Just make sure you have embedded fonts here, okay? So the fonts come in, and I'm going to leave everything as is. I'm just going to tap to, again, rename this to badge, hit enter return. I'm going to save that out back on the cloud, like so. Well, folks, thank you for spending time with me, learning some basic concepts on Affinity Designer, and a glimpse of what it can produce in such a short period of time. Let me know if you have any questions below the comments section, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share the knowledge.